Pisces, it's me, Stormy, and welcome to your February 2020 horoscope. We're Pisces. Let's take a look at this board. Look at this thing, okay? Look at all of these planets in this eastern, or to the left of your chart, hemisphere. Now, this particular placement, which is a node, is a point, not a planet. So as we look at this month, you have absolutely no planets on the Western Hemisphere. No planets, only a point. So what that tells us, just getting an immediate grasp of the juiciness that's coming for you this month, Pisces, is that this is a month that is about you. This is a month about your skills, your ability, your intuition, and how you use them, put them out there to take yourself forward. I also think this is what we call a personal independence peak, right? Because you're like, Pisces is having it Pisces way. It's like Burger King, but for Pisces, right? So this is an energy here where you could also find some people pushing a little bit against your ideas, but you're like, this is what's right for me. So you're going to find a lot of that happening because you don't have so many primary placements on the Western side, which is all about delving into and absorbing and adapting in our relationships. So you are in a personal peak, which is very exciting. Now, getting a personal peak where you get to make these moves also comes with great responsibility. With great power comes great responsibility, right? This is a time where it is very important, Pisces, for you to accept, grab onto responsibility for making your own happiness in your life, for adjusting the things that are not bringing a stream and a flow of happiness. But it is your job and responsibility this time to grab them and start to put in the effort, or continue the effort to grab your own happiness and not put it at the dependence of anyone else. So personal peaks are powerful, but they also require some work, okay? Let's take a look at what's going on this month. We have Mercury going retrograde, and it's retrograde in your sign. Mercury in your sign in general is not in his most comfortable position, but I don't think you're uncomfortable at all. In fact, what I think it does is help you be a little bit more direct and forward. So we'll get to see that motion and that movement, actually, of Mercury stepping down into your sign right at the beginning of the month on the 3rd. Mercury moves into the energy of Pisces. It lights up your first house here. You've already got your very comfortable ruling planet of Neptune. Venus has also been in your sign, encouraging you to take care of your body, take care of those feet, those legs. Those are the areas that you rule. Give yourself a little delicious pampering, right? Now, as Mercury comes in here, even though Mercury is in fall in your sign, which means he's not in full power, because Mercury wants facts, he wants details, and he wants them now. And you're like, I'm going to tell you how I feel. This doesn't feel right, or this feels off, or this feels good, right? Mercury's like, I don't know what that means. So while Mercury is visiting your sign, one of the things that's going to happen even for you is just pure logic is not the leader of the game. It's trusting the intuition. It's trusting the visions, allowing a vision to come to you, and then you run it through the mental process, things like that, right? But the other thing that I think Mercury helps you with, especially in a personal independence peak, is because Mercury's directness, he's going to try his best to get on board and do things with your characteristics, but he shines through. So this can help you be a little bit more direct. And maybe your version of being direct is not the same as my version of being direct, but what it does is help you to exchange information in a more direct fashion. Because when you exchange information, and your information may be based in empathy, it may be based in feeling, it may be based in some kind of creativity, when you share more directly that information, it's this jumping off point for people to heal, for you to heal, for you to make moves, for you to put yourself out there. So this does help you be a little bit more direct in this area and make some new decisions that are best for Pisces. On the 7th, Venus is getting out of the mix. She's going to move down into your second house. Now, Venus in the second house is traditionally very comfortable because she likes money and she likes relationships, but she really likes money, right? So Venus moving here into the energy of Aries is actually not her most comfortable sign. So Mercury and Venus are a little bit uncomfortable this month, but it doesn't mean that they're not effective. Venus moving here into Aries can make you a little bit more impulsive, can make you a little bit more assertive with your money. with your relationships. Venus in Aries, because Venus is still just a very diplomatic energy, but when she's working in the I energy of Aries, can make it so that you speak up for what you need here. Do you need a raise? Is it time for a raise? Is it time to charge more for your services? Is it time for your self-esteem to come up another level? You're in a personal confidence peak here. Could you be using that to get your skills and your talents and yourself out there in some way, shape, or form? This is a very impulsive energy too, though. So where you will want to be careful with Venus being over here in Aries is in how you're spending your money. Don't get so confident that you're like, yeah, I'm going to buy all of this stuff and it's going to work out. That's not necessarily the right path, but just be mindful and use the deliciousness that Aries is bringing to your table, okay? When we get to the 9th of the month, we're going to have a full moon happening in the energy of Aries, in the energy of Leo, excuse me. So it's going to light up over here in your 6th house. Now, the full moon says that something needs to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. A change and a shift needs to come to your daily routines, right? Now, Leo is an energy that is bold, energetic, original, very expressive. Thank goodness you have got some Mars energy helping you, or some Mercury energy. My goodness, you see you talk about the retrograde and then it just happens to you. Having Mercury over here and then also asking by this energy to express what you need in your daily routines and to look at it honestly in your daily routines, in your schedule, in your work life, and how you're getting things done, and how you're caring for your health, which includes your mental health, how you're talking to yourself, what's running through your head, what adjustments need to be made to make it original, to make it the best fit for this personally confident, independent Pisces over here. What do you need to adjust, acknowledge, or edit, or end over here that is maybe not as effective? This is where you get to craft and customize your own new daily routine. I also like this too because this could actually bring some work to your table, maybe a freelance project or something like that. Let's say, you know, photography or something with animals. This is a supporter for putting your own self-expression and creativity and art out into the world. So that's going to be a helper for you as well, which again, Mercury is going to make sure you get seen, okay? When we get to the 16th of the month, we see Mars now moving out of the energy at the top of your chart in your 10th house and moving into the energy of your 11th house. Now, I want to point out something to you. In the general reading, right, and this is a general reading, Aries is the ruler of the second house in the general reading, right? Mars is the ruler of Aries. So, as Mars in transit is moving in the general reading, we can see where changes to your money or your activity are going to come. Not only does Mars enter into the energy of Capricorn, and he's very comfortable there, very happy. Mars wants to do stuff. He's action and energy. He likes being busy and he likes moving and getting things done. Capricorn loves to get things done. They want to achieve. They want to succeed. So Capricorn gives Mars some structure for all of that energy, right? But what Mars is also going to bring in is some weight to your finances, your self-confidence, your self-esteem, anything financial as well. So as it moves here into the 11th house, what we know is that you'll be busy with friends, social groupings. They're already a big piece of your life with the heavy hitters of Saturn, Pluto, Jupiter up here, but now you're in action. You're in movement, you're in engagement in a very social way. And could it be that your art, your craft, your talent, something about you is getting out, being more expressive, being more original in a very social way? But whatever this social energy is, it will likely have financial benefit to you as well because Mars is the ruler of your second house energy, okay? I just want you to see when I say something like that or when another astrologer says that, that's what they're telling you. In the general, we can also follow what those energies are doing to see what other influences they'll bring in for you. Now, on the 17th, we have Mercury, who's here in your sign, gonna start his retrograde at 12 degrees, okay? So Mercury's going to retrograde at 12 degrees of Pisces, and then it will come out of the retrograde at 28 degrees of Aquarius, okay? Oh, of Aquarius. Let's go the other way, right? So your first and 12th houses will be impacted this time. But as Mercury begins this retrograde, first of all, when Mercury retrogrades, we go back. we reunite, we reconnect, we reconvene, we re-edit, we rethink, we revise, we do any of those going back to
so
things.
So as Mercury is retrograde here in your first house, I think that it gives you a good signal to go back over you. Right? Go back over your identity, the way that you're showing up in the world in a very physical way. Go back over your external environments, your identity. But also, this may just be an energy that has you thinking about going back to a certain situation or going back to a job or going back to a project or an idea, Mercury, that you had before, that you're willing to put yourself and your work and your ideas out into the world in a different way that is much more seen. And remember, you've got help to do that. Maybe you're just getting a lot of support in this social zone where people are saying, yeah, I really like your pictures. Yeah, I really love your salon. Yeah, I really love that. Whatever it is that you do, and you get the help and support to go back over something you've already seen and get ready to launch it back forward. Because the retrograde will continue into the 12th house, but it's Aquarian energy, it does tell me that I think you will be going back to something with a heavy social connection as well. On the 19th, we see the sun moving down here into the energy of Pisces, lighting up your first house. So happy, happy birthday, Pisces, okay? Light, heat, energy, vitality, and essence are right here. You're motivated. This is a personal pleasure peak for you. This is a personal get it together peak, but it's not terrible. It's actually quite delicious. And the sun has you motivated. Literally, the sun has you motivated. So I think there's a fair amount of movement that still gets to happen during this retrograde, but again, it may come through a very social place, and it may come through a lifting of your self-esteem or something around your values as well, okay? When we get to the 20th, we've got this aspect I want to point out to you, okay? Jupiter is here in your 11th house, but he's going to come into a sextile with your first house with Neptune, okay? Now, traditionally, in older astrology, Jupiter is one of your ruling planets anyways, so this is actually kind of a comfortable little dance that they're doing together. But in a sextile, it's a pocket of opportunity that you take wise advantage and action of. That's why I say when the planets have sex, that's good for us, because we're going to do something intelligent and wise with it, right? Now, Jupiter here is coming into contact with this Neptune, which is always an idea of ideals. In these social spheres, in these social zones, any place where you are social this month, Pisces, this is giving you an opportunity to look at your identity, look at yourself, and look at how you show up in these social situations and redefine or clearly define your ideals. Who are you, Pisces? What is your message that you're carrying? What are you about? What are you known for? What are the characteristics you want to grow into, or you want to be seen as, or you want to bring to these social groups? What are your ideals, right? And I also think, who is your ideal Pisces? It might be time at birthday time for you to relook at that, because it helps to reshape and show you where you can grow into these ideals and reshape that identity or shape the identity that you want going forward. If you've not been very visible for a long time or you're starting something new, you're going to have enough confidence to take it out there. And that may mean you've got to smooth off some sharp edges of your personality that didn't want to be seen or were not as strong as being seen or something like that. So reshape your ideals. The other part that I see about this is because Mercury is retrograde here, I think that what you have to do is you have to go back to something about you, something in your world, something about your identity, in order to move it forward and build a solid structure off of it. And sometimes I think we have this idea that if I take two steps back, I'm going in the wrong direction. But during a retrograde, you're absolutely not. You might need to take two steps back so that you can take a solid structural leap forward. And in a social way, it's very seen. So this becomes profitable down the road, okay? As we end the month, we're going to have a new moon happening right here in your sign, just past birthday time. I think that the new moon is always a nice birthday gift for us, right? When the sun and the moon are together, absolutely anything is possible. It is in your sign. What do you want for yourself going forward? Plant these seeds of intention for the Pisces you'd like to see, the Pisces you'd like to be, your ideas that you'd like to be spread. What does that look like for you? In your prayer and in your meditation, maybe even in some solitude time you need to take for yourself. Who do you want to be, and what's the fresh start, fresh perspective, freshness that you'd like to bring to your solar annual year, huh? Good month, I think. I do think it's a good month. I love that sextile. I can't wait to hear how this plays out for you. Please put it in the comment section down below. I'd love to see how this manifests for you for sure. All right, you guys, thank you for your grace as I'm learning the new space and lighting and all of that good stuff. We'll keep perfecting it over here. But like the video, comment, share, subscribe, and I look forward to seeing you next month, okay? Bye, Pisces.